الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله الذي جعلنا مسلمين الحمد لله على نعمة الإسلام وكفى بها نعمة من قالها ظلت الملائكة تحصي له حسناته حتى يوم القيامة الحمد لله على نعمة الإسلام وكفى بها نعمة وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله من قالها وجبت له الجنة وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت وسلمت وباركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد أحبابي في الله We were speaking last Friday about the day of Friday. How much we are blessed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gifted us the day of Friday to be our day, our weekly Eid. Eid every week. And we need to know exactly why we are making, we are celebrating today this Friday. And we have counted around 7 events happened on Friday and you are celebrating them. First, it is the day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala established himself over the throne. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is the day هو اليوم الذي استوى فيه المولى عز وجل على العرش. It is the day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala collected or ordered it to be collected, the Jum'ah. What is the Jum'ah? The piece of clay from which we were created. So we are celebrating Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is celebrating us today. This is the relationship between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the respectful, the decent relationship between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Physically, you are related to him more than your parents. سبحان الذي خلق الأزواج كلها مما تنبت الأرض. This is your body, grown up from this earth. ومن أنفسهم. This is from your parents, the quality of your body. Black, white, sharp eyes, not sharp eyes. Any quality of your body related to your parents. وَمِمَّا لَا يَعْلَمُونَ This is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the whole thing. You are physically related to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you mentioned that He loves you 99 times your parents. So you can't ignore Him. So many people ignored Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They don't even remember Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us to come to pray here Friday just to remember him. To remember him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Habibi Fillah, if you have a friend and traveled away from you for a year and he never wrote you a letter, he never phoned you, he never, and he came back even without anything in his hand for you, you will be depressed. This is not a friend. He forgot me once he left. He remembers only what is in front of his eyes. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with you all the time. You will have to remember him all the time. All the time. And this is libas of taqwa. He will wear a libas from taqwa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised this libas and he said, khayr. The best libas is libas of taqwa, ahbabi fillah. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Libas, when you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as much as you can, you don't have, you will never be, habibi fillah, 100% sure of your sins. You will never. But as much as you can, just to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will change the list of your bad deeds into hasanat. Even into hasanat, ahbabi fillah. Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ولا تقوم القيامة إلا في يوم جمعة. This is the main point, أحبابي في الله. That is why you are here celebrating the day of قيامة in advance. In advance, حبيبي في الله. How much happy you should be. We are only worried about the day of قيامة. A proper Muslim is only worried about the day of قيامة. What else you have to worry about? Your rizq, it is in his hand, subhanahu wa ta'ala. What about your health? In his hand, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your children is his hand, subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's him that will grow them. Will grow them. هو الذي سيثبتهم نباتا حسنا. Because you are a taqi. What else? Your wife, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will adjust her for you. Because you are a taqi. Habibi, what else you worry about? What else? That is why, Habibi fillah, you only worry about how much you are a taqi. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, listen to this bit. المسلمين, not everybody, only yourself. And the Muslimun, أحبابي في الله, it is only your service. Any other way, it is not. It is ridda. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. And in short, because of the time, حبيبي في الله, يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم, تعرض الخلائق, يعرض أحبابي أصحابي, which is your service, because you are his أصحاب as well. أصحابي يعرضون علي يوم القيامة. This is before العرض على الله سبحانه وتعالى. Before you see Allah سبحانه وتعالى, you will see النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. So that's it. It is enough بشرة, حبيبي في الله. It is enough to see صلى الله عليه وسلم first. صلى الله عليك وسلم يا حبيبي يا رسول الله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about him 1,700 times in the Quran. He is the best one to tell you about him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 1/5 of the Quran about the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And each word is carrying meanings as much as a cargo of a lorry. This is the word of the Quran. The difference between the Quran and the other talk is like the difference between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Quran is a miracle, ahbabi fillah, is a miracle. When he says subhanahu wa ta'ala, see on which level Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put the Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. I am celebrating, I love Al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Join us, me and my malaika. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Still, صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. Order. In 1,700 times in the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praise al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A very good example. Just to try to do as much as you can, like him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is his sunnah. Sunnah means his way. So his way will just follow him. So his followers are his sahaba. And if you are not his followers, if you are not following him, like so many groups nowadays, they are not following at all, and they are calling themselves Muslims. For instance, صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول, everybody is wearing a qamis, means a jilbab. You can call this qamis. Everybody is wearing in the day of Qiyamah a qamis. So the Muslimin are not going to be undressed like the rest of the nations. Isn't this enough? Habibi fillah, if you are عزكم الله في بيت الخلاء in the toilet, and somebody come by mistake, push to the door, you will be, because you don't want anybody to see you. In the day of Qiyamah, we will walk up with nothing. But you will be dressed, libas al-taqwa, libas al-islam. Only the Muslims that will be dressed. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم, فمنهم من هو يلبس ثياب until his neck. So there's only his ثياب is around him. Because his taqwa was too little. He was us in the masjid and outside going to the bar tomorrow on Saturday. His taqwa is too little, حبيبي في الله. ومنهم من هو لباسه حتى صدره. Cover until here. ومنهم من هو لباسه until his middle. That is good. He is covered. He covered his awra. Alhamdulillah. ومنهم من هو لباسه until the floor. حتى الأرض. ومنهم من هو يبر لباسه خلفه قيل ومن يبر لباسه خلفه يا رسول الله قال رأيت عمر أراني الله عمر يبر ثيابه خلفه عمر بن الخطاب أحبابي في الله كان من أتقى الأتقياء وكان حبيب الله. يقول الإسلام ويأتي الإسلام كرجل يقول يا رب أعزني أو أعزني إسلام هذا الرجل. كنت في عز حلم هذا أسلم. At least to be proud of your Islam. At least to be happy you are a Muslim. At least to show the others that you are a Muslim. أحبابي في الله, be proud of it. So you will be dressed of your Islam in the day of Friday, the day of judgment. Be proud. Even if you are the only Muslim in on earth. Like Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. حبيبي في الله, be proud you are the only Muslim on earth. حبيبي في الله يدر ثيابه خلفه ورأيت له قصرا and I have seen a palace for عمر. I thought it was mine. So I asked the angels, whose palace is this one? They said it is عمر. عمر بن الخطاب صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يحب عمر بن الخطاب هذا الحب. هذا الحب حبيبي في الله. And a group of Muslims making a video on the TV and so many TVs I can see, they are عزكم الله saying bad words. I am not going to mention about عمر and أبي بكر and علي أحباب رسول الله. Who said الله الله في أصحابي من أحبهم فبحبي أحبهم. If you love me, you are loving them. If you love رسول الله, love the Muslims. You love رسول الله, love your brother. And love all the Sahaba generation before generation until his Sahaba that were with him. That's all, حبيبي في الله. يقول المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم, let's get it from another bout because I was involved in some conferences. In this matter, and I said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, did he say, you know that he did he say, ما بعثني الله سبابا ولا لعانا أو كما قال المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. He never said a bad word about a human being. Whosoever. At all. Even about Abu Jahl, he never called him anything. صلى الله عليه وسلم. That is why Allah سبحانه وتعالى praised him. وإنك لعلى خلق عظيم. عظيم. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى give to us this degree. You have the best behavior ever on top of humanity. صلى الله عليه وسلم. Never. ما بعثني الله سبابا أو لعانا. So you are not supposed to curse anybody. You are not supposed to say bad words to anybody. Any human being, حبيبي في الله. Those people are just their job. Their prayer is to curse whom? The Sahaba. The Sahaba, أحبابي في الله. And they are wearing big imam. And sitting on TVs, and they are saying, so, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, do you deny that sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made Umar walk before him once he said, la ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah, before him to lead the group? Sallallahu alayka wa sallam, ya habibi, ya Rasulullah, wa radiyallahu anka wa an ashabik. Abi Bakr al-Siddiq, ahbabi filayhi, if we are going to speak about his seerah, I won't finish until next Friday night now. I won't stop, حبيبي في الله. I'll tell you just a little bit because of the time in this khutbah, inshallah ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله. اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك عليك يا حبيبي يا رسول الله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليك وعلى كل من اتبعك من المسلمين. أحبابي في الله, أحبابي في الله, أبي بكر الصديق every day used to leave his the masjid after عصر and go to a house far 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 away and stay there and come before Maghrib tired. And when his brain, he was crying and tearing so much that sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لو وزن إمام الأمة في كفة وإمام أبي بكر في كفة لرجحت كفة أبي بكر. أبي بكر has إيمان as much as the إيمان of the whole أمة. صلى الله عليه وسلم said that. Should they hate him? There is no word, the word hate doesn't exist in his dictionary, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The word hate, the word sab, to call anybody bad words, it doesn't exist in his mental dictionary, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So if you want to ask Allah, you will have to clear your mental dictionary of these words. The word sabba wa la'la doesn't exist in his mental dictionary, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So how you are making your prayer la'la and sabba? Are you a Muslim? Are you a Muslim? No, you are murtad. من سب صحابة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فهؤلاء هم المرتدين وتجب على الأمة مقاومتهم. This word I said it in so many conferences, أحبابي في الله, and I will keep saying it until I meet Allah سبحانه وتعالى. If you are going to keep cursing the Sahaba of Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you don't repent before you meet him subhanahu wa ta'ala, so you will meet him as a murtad wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi alayhi wa sallam. Sallallahu alayka wa sallam ya Habibi ya Rasulullah. And then he used to go there, and Umar ibn Khattab, a sense of responsibility you will have to have it in your heart about Islam. Where this man goes? And then keep from after Asr until Maghrib, we're waiting on the steps of the masjid and looking when he's gonna come. And when he's gonna come, looking at him, seeing how much he is tired. He can't walk, he can't walk. Sallallahu alayhim wa sallam ajma'in. Ahbabi fi Allah, radiallahu anhum wa ardahum. Until one day, after Abu Bakr came and after they prayed Maghrib, he went, rushed himself, Umar ibn Khattab, by his own, to this house, to see what is there. He found a disabled lady with two children, her daughters, both of them. And she is lying in her bed, and the children are playing. And the house used to be a room circled with a fence. This is the house. The house is at that time. So tell to her, oh lady, the man that comes to you, to you every asr, what he is doing? A question. So she said, he comes in order to clean for me the house. Listen to Amir al-Mu'mineen. Amir al-Mu'mineen, the leader of 50 of 68 nations today, Ahbabi Fillah. He comes to clean the house and to feed the Shah and to cook food for me and my children, and help me to get clean, to pray. يعني بيوضيها أعزكم الله أو بيتسلها. And help me to get clean, to pray. And after cooking the food and feeding us, he goes. أجوب أحبابي في الله, the home help of the government could stay five people a full day doing it. Abu Bakr is doing it by his own. So Umar ibn Khattab يبكي هذا الجهبذ بكى وقال قد سبقني إلى الجنة أبي بكر. They were not sitting just cursing the others, أحبابي في الله. سبقني إلى الجنة أبي بكر went to Jannah before me. This is the only thing they were competing for. And this is the only thing you should compete for. Don't worry about your risk. Don't worry about your state. Don't worry about your home. Don't worry about your children. Don't worry about anything in dunya that is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Worry about how much, how fast you are going to be in Jannah. Habibi fi Allah, this is the issue. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعلنا في هذا اليوم المبارك من أهل الجنة. اللهم إياك نسأل يا مولانا العظيم أن تهدي عموم المسلمين وأن توحد كلمتهم وأن تجمع شملهم. اللهم إياك أسأل يا مولانا العظيم أن تغفر لنا ذنوبنا. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا واشفي لنا مرضانا وارحم موتانا واهدي لنا عيالنا وأزواجنا وزوئينا. اللهم إياك نسأل يا مولانا العظيم أن تجعلنا من أوائل المسلمين. May الله سبحانه وتعالى make us the first Muslims. May الله سبحانه وتعالى make us with Prophet محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم in the day of judgment. May الله سبحانه وتعالى يسترنا to get us لباس خير in the day of judgment, not to show anything of us to anybody. نسألك اللهم يا ربنا أن تسترنا دنيا وآخرة. ربنا ولا تظل لنا في ساعتنا دي ذنبا إلا غفرته, ولا همّا إلا فرجته, ولا دينا إلا قضيته, ولا ميت إلا رحمته، ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا ولا الآخرة إلا قضيتها لنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. أسألك اللهم يا ربنا أن تعطي كل من حضر هذه الجمعة مسألته. أسألك اللهم يا ربنا أن تتقبل دعاء كل من حضر هذه الجمعة. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept the dua. Everybody attend this salah. أسألك اللهم يا ربنا أن تأتينا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وأن تقينا عذاب النار. ربنا آتنا من لدنك رحمة وهيئ لنا من أمرنا رشدا. وصلى اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم، والحمد لله رب العالمين.